G'day, gang, game, Mulio, Danny. How you going? We're back in the Elder Scrolls Online in this... not Somerset. Merkmire. We're in the Merkmire now. Somerset was the last series. This is the next series. Alright. So we're going to return to the Brightthroat Village. And then that should conclude this quest, and then we'll lead back onto the main quest. There was a patch just before I loaded in. I wonder if that's resolved a few of those FPS drops I was getting previously, when it seems to be a lot more smoother. Or maybe that's just because it's totally overcast and dark now, and we're not getting the brilliant light flashing through. Yeah, we'll see. So far, so good. Okay. Back to the tree minder.
Tree minder, if you saw what I saw, there would be no question.
If you hadn't run, you might understand.
Peace. Here is the one I must hear from.
Tree minder Pavu.
Beekojel, I have heard much of the tragedy of our loss. And the part you played in ending it. The Hist chose wisely to entrust our troubles to you. We owe you much already, but I have one last request for you.
What is it?
If you would hear it.
What is it you need?
Hasara betrayed us in ways beyond my imagining. Iskanaz is right to be wary, but when I look upon her and her daughter, I feel only pity. You know the truth of this tragedy better than I ever could. It should be you that decides Hasara's fate.
What does the Hiss tell you?
I can sense its relief. The calm of knowing that its children no longer suffer. What that means for Hasara's daughter is unclear. Our Hiss does not answer me about Hasara. I feel its faith in us. So I put my trust in you.
I need to think about this.
Speak to the others. Return when you have decided.
Please, you have seen the horrors that Rina Kal wrought. She soaked that corruption into the very essence of her creations. We cannot allow her poisons to seep into our roots. I beg you.
You really think that she's... that much of a danger to your tribe?
You think me cruel to believe so? I swear to you, it gives me no joy. One day, I might even forgive Hasara for what she's done. But if there is even the smallest chance that showing her pity will harm the tribe, I will close my heart 1,000 times.
What do you propose we do with them?
They should go, far away from our tribe and our Hist. From any Hist, never to trouble us again.
What if I decide she should stay?
If the Hist believes you are right, then you are right. I will have to hope we did not misjudge its intentions.
You know it's not true what Iskanaz is saying about her. You know it. He's a coward. She needs the Hist. It can help her.
What if your daughter really is a threat to the Hist? You've caused a lot of harm already.
She can't be. She just can't. If they won't accept us, I'll take her somewhere else. We'll have each other. That's all we need.
Even if you stay, there's no guarantee that your daughter will change for the better.
That doesn't matter. I'll love her however she is. If I have to care for her until my dying day, I will.
This is not a simple matter, nor a matter to be rushed. Take all the time you need. Hasara and Iskanaz will both want to plead their case to you, but I will understand if you do not wish your judgment to be swayed.
How would you punish Hasara for what she's done?
I can think of no tribe that has had to weigh such a crime. There are many who would put her to death for far less. But that is not the Brightthroat way. If we cannot find it in ourselves to forgive, then we will forget. Exile is my answer.
And if I asked you for mercy?
It is often easier to clip a withered branch for the sake of the whole tree. But with thought and care, a troubled limb can regain its strength. Hasara and her daughter are broken boughs, but they may yet be mended if we make the effort to heal them.
I'm ready to make my decision.
Then I will hear you as I hear our chimes. What is our stream's course?
You should accept them back to your tribe.
I feared I was being sentimental, but I am relieved to hear you offer them compassion. The Brightthroats have always navigated treacherous waters by linking arms and unifying our strength. Today shall be no different.
I wish you the best.
There will always be a place among our tribe for these two, and for you, Biko. I would be honored to call you Rootkin for what you've done for our tribe. Make yourself at home here. You have earned a rest. Come, Hasara. We have ignored your pain for too long. Now it is our pain, and we will overcome it together.
Okay.
Come, my love. Let's go home.
Feels right. Feels right. Okay, Iskanez doesn't want to... He doesn't want anything to do with us now. Alright, let's go. He'll be right. He'll be right.
We should look at your child, Hasara. You as well. The healing hut will be quiet.
Give her a minute more. She's overwhelmed. It's all right, dear.
Okay, where's Zuckus? Zuckus? Where are you, pal? Are you down below? Okay.
The brightest, loudest throats croak your name, Biko. This makes it difficult to sleep, but under the circumstances, I think I can forgive you. That business with the egg tenders was no midday wallow. Now we have something to discuss, I think.
I need to find the remnant of Argon.
Of course you do. This matter of the remnant, you must understand, it is fragile as a marsh robin's egg. Even so, I trust your heart. And truthfully, we could use the help. Brightthroats are negotiators, not warriors. And war is brewing.
Thank you. How should we proceed?
All answers lie with the Hist. It is just a matter of hearing what it has to say. Chime Maker Shuvu can help us. Our Hist speaks through the wind, you see. Its words rustle through the boughs, and our chimes sing out its counsel. Poetic, right?
Where can I find this Chime Maker Shuvu?
Old Shuvu spends his time in the Glade of Chimes, to the west of the village. In my youth, I would spend all my time listening to the chimes. It is a very good place. If you go there now, I will join you.
All right, let's find Chime Maker Shuvu and the Glade of Chimes.
You will like Chime Maker Shuvu, I think. Very wise and very pleasant. Like one of your gray-muzzled bark dogs. Let's make our way to the glade.
Why is everything related to the dogs? Did people not see that person that just walked over here and got stabbed and died? There's no body. Maybe there was nothing. Maybe I'm seeing things. And nobody cared. Not a single person batted an eye. eyelids were unbattered.
Your betrothed await you, dear suitors. No need to be shy. Everyone gets the jitters, but this is ridiculous.
Try and make a shiver.
Is that... little Zookas. Come to visit your old friend in the Glade of Chimes? He is always so busy now. I recall when he stood only as tall as the Kepo grass. And you, Xavier. What can this stiff-legged crafter do for you?
I need to ask you, or ask your Hist, about the remnant of Argon.
Remnant of... My. This is no small question, Zookas friend. Look around you. Each of these chimes sing out a tangle of melodies, but only one tangle. One chime speaks of eggs and hatching, another jangles about death and journey's end.
So I need a specific chime? One that speaks about the remnant?
The Ogel is clever, Zookas. Yes, my hands gave birth to every chime you hear, but the remnant... Only one chime can sing its truth. One made by sun-blessed hands in an old time. Older than my egg mother. A chime as old as our tribe.
Where is this chime?
Locked away, hidden under mud and lost memories. Understand, our egg sires did not want this truth drifting free on the wind. But Zookas trusts you. So I will trust you. Go to the Wither Vault. Claim the chime. We will learn its truth together.
All right, so I'll recover the chime from the Wither Vault.
The Wither Vault is well north of the village. I would guide you, but my knees grow stiff as kindling wood. Little Zookas can aid you, I have no doubt. Be warned. Even bright throats who know the mire like their own scales face danger there.
All right, Zookas, little Zookas. We're traveling north, my friend.
The path to the remnant bends like an oxbow. Let's find this chime. Leaving the glade always puts rocks in my sandals. Sad, you know. One day the two of us should share some phlegm wine there and just listen.
Did you just say phlegm wine? I bet you have the phlegm wine. You can have mine as well. I'll listen, though. I'll listen to your stories.
Sick here. A far cry from Lilmoth's mud puddles, I think. Leviathan Pizzle grows across this glade. A very powerful herb, Biko. Remind me to pick some later. I cannot imagine the Brightthroats ever holding territory here. Very little wind, hollow seeds, and poor fishing. Take away our wind, seeds, and fish, and we grow. There it is, just up ahead. This place dries my scales.
Zookas, you gotta... I don't know, maybe you need to have a little bit of a break between all that information that you were given to me. I was actually trotting fairly slowly.
No good thing comes from stone. Let's make this quick.
Trotting along very slowly. Maybe we should have just ran. Aha.
I fear we will find more than the chime inside this vault. Be careful.
Yep, you too, mate. Look at this thing. I wonder if it's only purpley like that at night time. During the day we wouldn't see that.
The Nahish elders never speak of this place. Not even to me. Stay watchful, Biko.
Hang on, mate.
Something.
Hang on a second.
Chimes. They sing without wind. Just ahead. Kayak, I hate this.
Champion of the Hiss Girdle. Oh, hello. I'll take that. I threw that on so quickly, I didn't even really look at it. Sturdy reduces the cost of block by 3%, adds 339 maximum health. Nice. Okay, Okay, what do we got? Remnant chime. Bunch of bookshelves. It's not gonna be that easy. It ain't gonna be that easy. So I'm gonna read my books first. We are not gonna be able to just take this. A large stone tablet that represents the ninth month of the Argonian year, otherwise known as the Lizard. Okay. I don't know. I was meant to take that or not, but anyway. The Remnant Chime, an ancient, masterfully created, crafted chime. According to the Brightthroats, its hollow tones can tell us more about the remnants of Argon. Oh, okay. I guess it is that easy. I was expecting...
Good work, Bigo. Let us get back to Brightthroat Village.
Expecting a little bit more than that. Like a cave-in or a... I don't know, anything. Anyway. I wonder what that stone tablet's for, though. Alright, back to the village we go. Oh, bit of a drop. Up. Yep.
No need to be shy. My rage quill is engorged. Be calm. This is ridiculous. What's going on? The wind welcomes you, Zuka's friend. You have the remnant chime? Please, settle an old lizard's spines. The beast Zuka's mentioned, it did not gnaw or shed water on it, right?
What? What beast? What are you talking about? No, it seems fine. What happens now?
Hist be praised. Take the chime to the listening tree and hang it there. When you are ready, clutch this prayer stone and focus. If your cause is just, the Hist will answer. If not, I guess we have to find a better place to bury this chime.
I'll hang the chime. I wonder if there was a fight meant to take place prior, because it just seemed a little bit easy for us to walk on in. Rock on in and take that thing off. Anyway.
Perfect. Now center yourself in the glade and focus the remnant's mystery on the prayer stone.
Go to the prayer mat. Use Argonian prayer stone.
We seek your guidance and ask the blessing of your song. Sap Mother, Bow Father, please hear our petition and speak the remnant's truth. I hear nothing. A tangle of whispers, nothing more.
That can't be. Wait, I hear it, Shuvu. I hear it. The Hist sings the remnant's truth.
Truly? Ha! Ah, little Zuka's, I knew you had a chime maker's heart. Come, tell us what you hear.
I am confused. Shuvu is the wisest listener in the tribe. How could he hear nothing when I heard it so clearly? He is very old. Maybe he just needs his ear cavity flushed.
I doubt it. What did the chime say about the remnant of Argon?
Smoke of stars to see what once was seen. Sunless sap to hear what once was heard. A bramble of words. I appreciate the Hist's poetry, but this is not an ideal time for it, I think.
How will this help us find the remnant of Argon?
I do not know, Hopefully Shuvu can teach me how to decipher the words. It will take time, but I will find you if I learn more. Perhaps friend Famia could help also? Or Cassandra? They both know the marsh's stone secrets. They could prove useful.
Cassandra asked me to meet her in Alten Mirlil. I'll see if she can help. Which is where? Over here. Found a pack with a romantic poem and frog totem in the middle of the swamp. If I return these items to the rifle owner, I may receive a reward. Okay, maybe we should receive that reward first. Is there a way shrine in the area? I don't see one. But it's not too far away either way. Either way. Over the top. There's the way shrine. This road here.
I just heard someone found Donlay dead on the road.
No, poor
Donlay. Aha, here we go. Shalmat. I believe this belongs to you.
Your steps show determination, and your eyes curiosity. Tell me what you seek, Beagle.
Did you lose this frog totem and poem?
Yes. I carved this many seasons ago. I hoped it would convince my beloved Kudnakal to join me for our tribe's next bonding ritual, but I lost the totem before it could be presented. Of course, this was when I was still a female.
You used to be a female?
The Hist, in all its endless gifts, allows us to change many aspects of ourselves. Our gender is but one. I highly recommend such a change, should you ever get the chance.
So, because you're now male, you can't bond with Kudnakal?
If we had spoken a week ago, it would have been so. But as fate would have it, Kudnakal has recently undergone a change herself. Thank you for bringing me this letter and totem. They should make fine gifts for my beloved.
Okay.
I will present these gifts to Kudnakal when the next bonding ritual is announced. I simply must tweak my poem, perhaps refine my carving, and all shall be ready.
Okay. Fine. I might steal from your trunk. Goodness knows what all we'll find in there. Let's have a look at this. He gave us something that may be of interest. Tribal equipment crate. Brightthroat boast jerkin. I wonder why it's in a crate. Why don't they just give us the item? Thought if it was in a crate, I might be able to select. Okay, I want a plate piece rather than a light armor or whatever. Make a choice, you know? Alright, so we gotta meet Cassandra. There's a lot of quests here. I might have to take a break from the main quest and start trying out some of these quests here. Alright, but anyway. For now, let's go.
Your eyes are as lovely as muddy puddles.
Muddy puddles. Let's go and get our mount skilled up.
I've always...
Increase that capacity. Yeah, I cleared all the items out after we had finished Somerset, so hopefully the inventory will stay somewhat manageable for a while. I think we might just take the ride. Doesn't seem like there's any other way to get there. Really, I mean, that's not going to go in there. It's not going to save much time. Rock formation there. We should see Cassandra in a second.
Whatever will I do?
Oh, hello. Cassandra said you'd be here. There's news.